Hello everyone, today we are going to see how one can do the AC analysis in microcap. So I have already drawn a circuit here, so I will be showing you how one can plot the magnitude and phase of the signal at different nodes in the circuit. So go to the analysis, press the AC analysis button, and now you will see that there are multiple options in the limit. So here first one is the frequency range. Here you can see that I have specified the two frequencies. So the second one is the starting point of the frequency, and the first one is the end point of the frequency. The next is number of points. So these are the number of points your simulation will be done. And next one is temperature. You can change the temperature, but I am going to keep it 27. And there are other options also. And the important and main part is here defining the x and y expression. So since we are doing the AC analysis, I will plot it with the frequency. So you, for frequency, you have to specify f. For time, you have to specify t here. And the next one is the y expression. So here you can define the voltage or current of a particular node. So if you write V of 3, it will show the magnitude of the voltage at node 3. V1 will show magnitude of the voltage at node 1. You can also try to plot it in dB scale, so decibel scale. So you just need to write the dB before dB, and inside that bracket you can specify the voltage or current of that node. So I am going to plot it the exact amplitude in the linear scale, and then you can specify the phase. So I am plotting phase of V3, which is my input node, and phase of V1, which is the one end of our this register. So you can plot these signals at different plots, or you can merge them at on a single plot. So I am plotting the magnitude of signal at two different plots and phase of both the nodes on the same plot. So when I hit the run, you will see that I have applied the 1 volt at the input. So my V3 is at 1. So there is a resistive voltage divider network. So my output signal amplitude is a little less compared to what we have applied. And if you see the phase, so there is no phase change in the circuit. So that's why we are getting the zero phase shift in the